Welcome back to another Brainboxes video guide. In this video, we'll explain how to tunnel data between serial ports. This step-by-step guide shows how quick and easy it is to set up serial tunneling, and is designed to help both a tech-savvy and less experienced user. Serial tunneling allows the user to set up a network connection which can span any distance up to 40,000 kilometers or 25,000 miles, the circumference of the Earth. This can benefit many applications as it saves money on cabling and links devices far apart with a stable serial connection. For our initial setup, we'll use PuTTY to send data from one workstation to another via RS-232. You can find a link to download PuTTY in the description below, but you can follow these steps in another terminal emulator for the same results. To connect the terminals together, we'll need to know the COM port of each workstation, which can be found in Device Manager. In the first terminal, change the connection type to serial, the serial line to your COM port, and change the speed depending on your baud rate. On the second workstation, input your settings to PuTTY and click Open. PuTTY is now open to sending and receiving data over RS-232. What we type in one terminal will appear in the other. If we replace the RS-232 cable with a Cat5 Ethernet cable, we can extend the distance between devices. The key problem this solves is distance. The data rate of the serial connection determines the maximum distance the serial data can travel over cabling. Using a weighing scale, we can translate the data being sent from serial into Ethernet packets. We'll use Brainbox's Ethernet to serial ES246 on each workstation with a weighing scale at one end. To find your devices on the network, you'll need Brainbox's boost.lan software. A link can be found in the description below. Open boost.lan and press Find Devices Now. The ES products connected to your workstation will now display. Below the product ID, you'll find the device's IP address. Open up a web browser and go to your IP address. Ours is 192.168.200.101. Select the Network tab, set the IP to assigned static, and input your new IP. Now, if the devices are restarted, they will automatically stay on the IP address you assigned. The subnet mask and gateway address don't need changing, but this is best checked with your network team. To start tunneling, go to the Serial Port tab. Enable serial tunneling and enter the other ES device's IP address, checking the remote TCP port is correct. If we open PuTTY on our workstation and connect to the COM port, we can now send data from our weighing scale, and this will be replicated in our terminal. By configuring our devices to a LAN or WAN network, we can remove the need for cabling entirely. We'll add a Brainbox's Ethernet switch, SW005, to connect the devices together. Connect each ES device to a serial port and tunnel the Ethernet ports to the SW005. Using the IP addresses we assigned earlier, we can set the devices to tunnel. Now when we open PuTTY, the data we receive from our serial connection will appear, or we can type commands to appear on the other screen. Now the devices are connected to your network, there are no constraints on distance as long as one device is accessible to the other over IP. We have now demonstrated how to tunnel serial data between Ethernet to serial products, removing the need for cabling as we go. For more information on Brainbox's Ethernet to serial range, take a look in the description below. All of Brainbox's products offer lifetime warranty and support when registered through our website, so don't hesitate to get in touch with any queries or issues you may have. Don't forget to leave a like if you found this video helpful. Follow us on Twitter, LinkedIn, and sign up to our newsletters.